Hey guys, I'm Aloy Andalus from MPFX and Effective TDs. This video is a guide for basic concepts for choosing a laptop for 3D. Doesn't matter if it's 3D Studio Max, Houdini, Maya, or even if you need it for motion design or video editing, I think that all the requisites are valid for you. So here we will see some of the basic elements that you need to know and to have into account when you choose one or another laptop for your 3D work. First of all, you need to know if you are a Mac guy or a PC guy. A Mac guy, you have to choose between a MacBook Pro, and if you are a PC guy, you have plenty of options because you have a lot of companies creating laptops. It depends if you are used to work on a Mac environment or into a Windows environment. Right now, Macs, you will pay more for the same performance. PC with the same components will be always cheaper, but in exchange, Macs has a better screen quality. Normally, the build quality in general is better. For example, for 3D, in my opinion, I will never go for a Mac. Graphic cards in Macs are kind of limited. And in a PC, you have NVIDIA's Macs builds ATI, and they are not as good. As well, if you work, for example, in 3ds Max, it's only working on a PC. You can run Parallels and Bootcamp into a Mac, but I think that if you are a 3ds Max user, don't think even to go into a Mac. They are pretty good as well if you do mostly motion graphics and you want to do a little of 3D on the side. Obviously, it's totally possible. It's only that you will pay a premium to get the same components that you will have on a PC. Second very important question is, what screen size do you want? Right now there is mostly three screen sizes: 13 inch, 15 and 17. MacBooks stopped producing 17, and nowadays you will see less and less companies having this size. Mostly right now it's 13 or 15 inch, and it depends. Normally if you are at home, you will connect your laptop into an external monitor, so maybe with a 13 inch even you can work, but if you want to do a lot of work outside, minimum you need a 15 inch. And I stopped using 17 inch because they are too big. I found that the most portable is a 15. You are in a laptop, so you need, normally you want this portability. And what I like from the 15 inch is that it's the minimum size to have a numpad. For this reason, I never consider a 13 inch screen size. Also, you will see that 13 inch, since it's a smaller body, the performance will be lower, so you need to have this into account. On the screen, we have a lot of terminology. First of all, we have 4K and we have Full HD screens. Nowadays, for 3D, and if you are in a 15 inch or 17 inch even, I think that 1080p is quite enough. You have a lot of pixel density. A 4K panel, I think that for working 3D can be underproductive. For example, there is programs that don't scale so well on 4K on Windows yet, because each program needs to do its own thing. So you will have some programs that will scale good, but the other one not. And again, you are on a limited screen. Normally, if you connect it to an external one, you can go to 4K. If you can save money, I will go for the 1080p. Then we have the construction of the panel. Basically, we have TN and we have IPS. TN are the cheapest ones. Normally, if you go for a cheap laptop, you will have most probably a TN panel. The big difference, they are much faster on refresh rate, but on viewing angle, they are not so good. So if you move a little your viewpoint, you will see the colors shift, going horizontal or vertical. Color can change a little. For 3D, for me personally, I am totally fine with a TN panel. If you work a lot in post-production, you work in Photoshop, maybe you will need for IPS. IPS panels are a little more expensive. They don't have this problem that the color shifts when you move your view. Almost in all angles, the colors stay the same. They have lower refresh rates, even though they are improving it lately. With a lot of new gaming computers, they go to 140Hz. The refresh rate is nothing that you need to have a lot into account when you work in 3D. It's mostly for gaming. but always with a bigger refresh rate, it's more pleasant to the eye to read and to move. Then we have the color accuracy. The color accuracy is from the space of RGB, how color accuracy your panel can reproduce these colors. So you are looking normally for 100% color accuracy is good, 95% is good as well, and you will see that maybe with a TN panel you will have lower color accuracy. Again, for me, it's not something super important for a 3D production. And finally, we have matte and glossy, and it's a personal taste. I prefer matte, so it will kill a little the reflex. Glossy, you will have a lot of reflex on your screen. For some people, they like it because the colors looks more vibrant. It's a personal taste. Keyboard. It's something that not a lot of people talks about, but for me, it's super important. If I don't have a numpad on my keyboard, I don't choose never this laptop because I am very used to work and to enter digits on my numpad. For sure, you can connect an external one, but I need it. The other thing to consider is the travel distance. On the new MacBook Pros, they start this trend with a butterfly mechanism that you have less than 1 millimeter of travel distance. Travel distance is how deep your keyboard goes. So if you want to have the feeling, in 3D, even we are not writing a book, we press a lot of keys during the day for shortcuts, and for me it's quite important. The best thing to know if you like it or not is to try the keyboard. Close to 2 millimeters for me is way better. I tried the MacBook Pros and they are super shallow, and it's something that I guess that you get used to it, but try it before buying. And other things, the backlighting for me it's nice, but it's not something that I will consider for buying a laptop. If it has backlighting, for me it's a little better. And some laptops have a very weird key distribution. You will see that the shift or the control are longer, or that they are placed differently. If you jump from one computer to another and you have one laptop with a different key distribution, can be frustrating when you jump from one to another. CPU. CPU is very important. We are in 3D, we are doing heavy stuff. We need a good CPU. And you have the new 8th gen of Intel. You have the i5, then you have the i7, and then you have the i9. I will not consider even the i5 nowadays. I will go for an i7. On this 8th gen, we have 6 cores on the i7. 12 threads on a mobile processor. Before, on the previous gen, we had only 4 cores, so it's a big jump on the i7, and mostly you will be able to do almost anything with that. You are not supposed to render on a laptop, but nowadays it's totally possible, and you can keep your laptop rendering for 2 or 3 nights, no problem. Now we start seeing some laptops with the i9. There was a lot of problematic with the Macs with the i9. I will not go so extreme. The i9 has a bigger clock speed. Think that even it's the same thermal design, you need to refrigerate these things. And when the turbo boost goes on, if the chassis of your laptop is the same as the i7, at 100% rendering, you will have problems and you are paying a big premium to have the best of the best. I think that the sweet spot is on one of these two i7s. The most common I see in laptops is the i7-8750H. This H is also very important. It means that it's a mobile processor. On the previous generation, it was HQ. We can see it here, the 8750 versus the 7700 from the previous gen. And you can see that with multiple core speed, that is what you will have when you are rendering, we get almost 50% increase between the previous generation. That is a lot. If you don't have this H, you have a U. It's kind of confusing, but you have Intel's i7 and i5 with ending with a U and an Y. Don't consider these ones. Some Chinese laptops go with these ones. Has a lower TDP, so instead of 45, they go to 15 watts, and they do so reducing a lot core threads and the base clock speed, and I will not consider for a 3D work. We are only looking at Intel's here because AMD on laptops, they are doing a good job with Threadrippers, but we didn't see any Ryzen graphic cards. Nowadays, laptops has a very good graphic cards, and it's thanks to Nvidia. On AMD, there is almost they are not at the same level. So that's the reason I am not a big fan of a Mac to work in 3D. But since the 10X series from NVIDIA, they did a very good job and almost performed the same as a desktop graphic card. Since I am doing this video, the 20X series are coming, the RTX, but there is not so much to talk about. We need to check benchmarks and everything, so we will talk about the 10X family. You need to consider as well the TDP for these graphic cards. Even if you spend a lot of money and you want a slim, kind of a slim laptop, you cannot go with a 1080, because as you can see, the TDP on a 1080 is, it goes from 90 to 150 compared with a 1060 that goes between 60 and 80. This means that when you jump from one graphic card to the other, you will need to have a bigger laptop, or it will be much more noisy, it will produce much more heat. There is a lot of implications because we are in a laptop, it's not like a desktop PC that we can simply add a bigger fan. We are in a limited space, and you have as well the Ti versions. Right now I see a lot of laptops with a 1060, and I will say that it's a sweet spot. You are in a laptop, don't try to go with a 1080 if you don't want to go with a 5 kilos laptop. 1060, maybe 1070, 1070 I will say it's kind of borderline. And on top of that, you get the Max-Q designs. NVIDIA introduced Max-Q last year, and basically it's a series of specifications. They undervolt a little his graphic cards. So if you have a 1060 Max-Q, it means that it has the 1060 core undervolt. So it will perform like a 1050 Ti, but with the advantage that it will be much more quiet, it will produce less heat and less noise. RAM memory. Nowadays, most of the laptops, they come with 16 gigs if you go for $1,000 computer. And in 3D with 16 gigs, nowadays you can do a lot of things. I will consider, maybe if you do a lot of effects, go higher, and maybe you will need 32 gigs. So it's good if you have one slot free. There is some laptops, not all, but instead of coming with two RAM slots of 8 gigs each one, they come with one single 16 gigs RAM slot. So then if you want to ampliate that, you simply need to buy another 16 gigs and you have a total of 32. If you would like to go higher than 32 gigs, it's only possible on bigger models, so you will need a 17-inch laptop. Most of the 15-inch laptops, the maximum that you can go is 32 gigs. That is not so bad. Hard drive. Hard drive is something that I don't look so much. It's something that you can upgrade very easily if you don't have a Mac. So in Windows it's pretty easy that if you need more space, you simply buy a new one, or you can connect an external one. So basically check that at least it has an SSD of 128 gigs or 256. Personally with 128 gigs, I have installed three versions of 3ds Max. I have installed Houdini, I have Blender, After Effects, all the Adobe Suite, and everything fits on 128 gigs. And on top of that, I have Windows, obviously, installed on this partition. Maybe 256 will be better, but I have enough space. For all additional data, it's a good idea to have a mechanical drive. 1 terabyte or 2 terabytes is fine. Mostly you will need 2 terabytes if you work with a lot of data. You are an FX artist doing simulations in Houdini or 3ds Max. Go for bigger capacity. Trackpad. You will see in a lot of reviews they talk about trackpad, precision drivers. I don't give a shit about trackpad, because in 3D you will be always with a mouse, you need the middle button, and you will work much faster. So I will not even consider if a trackpad is good or bad. Simply connect a mouse, and wherever you work, you will work with a mouse. Connections. Connections are important. I do more stuff than 3D, so for me an SD card reader is really important to plug my photos to my laptop in an easy way. Ethernet cable, Ethernet connection is very important as well. Nowadays we are using it less and less because we have Wi-Fi, but as a freelance you can go to work on a facility where you need to connect to his LAN to share your files and you need to connect via Ethernet, for sure there is ways and dongles to connect your USB-C, convert it to Ethernet, but it's simply useful if you simply have it. USB also, for me it's important that I have USB 3.0. If there is some 2.0, I don't care because sometimes I connect the mouse. And the USB-C, I simply don't have any product that use USB-C. Building quality and aesthetics is something that will influence a lot the price that you will pay for your laptop. If you have a plastic body or you want an aluminum body, like the XPS 15, the Razer or some ThinkPads, that they are really sturdy. In the other hand, you can go for a cheaper version if you don't mind, with a gaming laptop made of plastic. But then you have to be careful with aesthetics. Gaming laptops, they have a lot of red accents and they look like a jet engine that will be able to fly. Nowadays, in 2018, we are seeing more and more neutral lines. If you need your laptop to go to a meeting with some clients, it's something to take into account as well. So these are some of the elements that I check before I buy a new laptop. Let me know what I forget to mention. There is a lot of things that I didn't talk about. I would like to know, write in the description, which laptop do you use? I will have mine on the comment section. And yeah, let me know if you are working on a Mac, one of these weird guys that work in 3D in a Mac, why you like it, and why do you choose the laptop do you have, or if you don't, you hate to work in a laptop. And please subscribe if you like the video, and see you soon.